opinions, you're not going to tell him. Well, not a bad point for him. When we first moved over to England.
Oh,
I'm scared now. I'm really scared.
You know what was a limb?
Oh, the most embarrassing thing was.
This is Bewitched, the record-breaking girl group. Here's Adele, the leader of the band. All the other girls are going to spill the beans on her bad habits. Now, Sinead has been dancing since she was 4 years old, so who better to teach us their dance moves? Kiwi is said to be the shy one, so let's find out exactly who she fancies. And Lindsay is the baby of the group. We'll be visiting her in her bedroom, where she will tell us a secret. I'm really excited. We're about to meet them, so come on.
Ladies,
hello.
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 Now you all look slightly different. Why is that?
Well, I've got my hair cut.
Yeah. Well, I haven't got black hair anymore.
My hair is long.
I've actually got a fringe.
Now, we haven't seen you for a while. Where have you been?
We've actually been in America. How would you describe America to someone who's never been there?
Big.
But not too big for America to take Bewitched to their hearts in 1999. These Irish tomboys covered the length and breadth of the United States to entertain an army of new fans. And while they were in America, they recorded the video for their new single, Jesse Hold On.
Adele, usually if we have to talk about anything on behalf of the band, the girls will get me to talk about it. And sometimes when we're having a conversation with other people, they will think that it's only me that's talking, but I'm actually talking on behalf of everyone else. And some people think, oh, she's very bossy. But it's not bossy, I just have to keep things in line sometimes.
Here we are on the tour bus and we're having a lovely home-cooked dinner.
Hi, I'm Lindsay. Some people would say that I'm laid-back and bubbly and giggly, but I can be serious sometimes, and I can be quite sensitive. And my main motto in life would be, everything happens for a reason, so don't despair if something goes wrong.
Hi, I'm Sinead, and some people think that I'm actually a thinker and I can be quite serious, but I'm funny in my own ways. And my motto in life is basically, be nice to people because what comes around goes.
I'm Kiwi. I think everyone would probably look at me as the laid-back one and they're dead right, because I tend to follow the crowd. If everyone else knows what we're doing and where we're going, I'll just go, yeah, leave it at that, just follow them. So I'm not very good when I get lost.
Bewitched are already record breakers in the UK, with all four of their singles flying straight into number one. But their story starts in Dublin, where 3 years ago, four teenagers put a few dance moves together.
I'm going to take you back to the early days now. Tell us about
the early days.
Remind us how it is you all got together, how Bewitched was born.
Well, it was about 3 years ago and we all danced in the same dance centre in Dublin, Diggs Lane it was called. And we sort of knew each other to say hello there, and then Kiwi worked as a mechanic and Sinead went to the garage and met Kiwi there, and then Lindsay and Kiwi ended in kickboxing together. Okay. So then we all thought, let's get together.
Now it's good that you should mention Diggs Lane dance. Yeah. I'm very pleased to have. Now do you remember when you were at Diggs Lane, a local TV show came to film?
Oh my god!
And you, look, here comes Sinead.
Kiwi!
Were you excited then to be on TV?
This is one of the first TVs we ended up doing, and after this they brought us into a studio and they watched us sing along to one of our songs actually, and then they invited us onto the programme the next week to perform on it.
What song did you perform?
A song we'd done ourselves called Shoulder to Cry On actually, and we performed it the next week, and that's how we met our manager.
You know, my favourite bit of this tape is, though, if I can whiz it forward.
No,
wait and see, this is classic.
We've all tried this, haven't we?
Pretending to have microphones.
Oh, yeah!
And they took a picture of me.
No, they didn't!
They totally did!
blonde hair.
Oh, yeah.
The girls went through several names, Desire, Sassy, Sister, and finally, the name which stuck.
Hi everybody, I'm Sinead.
Hi, I'm Lindsay.
Hi, I'm Adele.
Hi, I'm Kiwi.
And we're twin sisters, and we are Bewitched.
When did you decide on the name Bewitched?
Actually, when we met Ray Hedges, our producer, he gave it to us then. Thank God. Some of the names we had.
I think he didn't really want to work with a girl band at the time, and he said that we bewitched him because we changed his mind because he loved us.
So did one of you take the lead more so than the others, or did you all agree that, you know, this should happen?
It's quite strange, because when we sit back and try and remember what went on, we don't ever remember stopping at any stage and sort of going, like, what are we going to do next?
Yeah, there was always, we were always working towards something, and there was never any doubt,
and that was,
you know. never any time when we'd say, oh, what are we doing, you know, is this going to work? We were always, you know, driven to work towards something.
Okay, favourite things.
My favourite colour is blue.
Well, my favourite colour is purple. I've got a purple massage thing here.
His name is Harry.
My favourite thing that I would carry on the road with me would be this pillow. My nephew and my mum made it for me, and I carry it around with me for good luck. I lost it at one stage in the airport and I panicked. And I was like to everybody, if you see this pillow, you have to send it to me.
Favourite clothes would be my pajamas, because that means I'm going to bed.
My favourite hot water bottle
is Matt,
and I call him Matt for Mum and Dad, because when I'm not well, he looks after me when my mum and dad aren't here.
My favourite movie is, of all time, is Dirty Dancing, because I love the dance moves in it. They're really cool.
Right, friendship.
I think you meet certain people all the way through your life that kind of stick out, that you'll always kind of know that they'll always be there for you, and that's the most important thing.
I suppose it's just about making each other happy and being there for each other.
To me, friendship is someone who listens to you, listens to your problems, someone who really genuinely wants the best for you and doesn't get jealous of you.
The three girls are my closest friends. And I also have two closest friends at home as well, called Peggy and Sandra.
My best friends will be Kiwi, Lindsay and Sinead.
Oh yes I do, oh yeah. Never mind the stormy weather, pull all the clouds away, yeah, yeah. I
love. Oh, what's that again?
If they're quite romantic, and I like a gentleman, actually.
A few things that would kind of attract me to a boy would be a nice smile and somebody kind of affectionate.
If I fancy a boy, I suppose I just kind of feel, it makes me feel kind of shy around them, and I just want to talk to them all the time.
Someone that would let you look after them, but they look after you as well, and they listen to you, and I suppose basically that you feel really comfortable around each other.
Things I dislike about a boy, what would totally put me off, I suppose, would be just acting the lad and trying to be real cool with you. That wrecks my head.
A lot of boys actually would say things like, I'll call you in 10 minutes and they'll call you in 2 hours. And that's not a good thing.
Secret.
Well, if I was to tell you my deepest, darkest secrets, then they wouldn't really be secrets. But I'll tell you maybe a couple about the other girls.
I'll tell you something about myself, but you have to keep it a secret.
Kiwi has a secret passion for funny socks. She loves getting all these, like, coloured socks or socks with pictures on them or something, like.
Sometimes I snore.
So, Wiley, leaving you as promised, this ever girl band ever to get to number one. And that's straight in with their debut single, which is something that not even the All Saints or Spice Girls manage. They are Bewitched. See ya.
Look at the colours, it's so colourful.
Look at my hair, it's like a wig.
Amazing.
so happy doing it.
We look so bouncy and energetic.
I remember we were so excited, and then they made it look like the video with all the flowers, so we were like, that's so nice, they made such an effort.
Did you have a good idea that you guys were doing
No, not at all. Do you know what, we didn't have any idea whatsoever, and everybody kept telling us at the radio stations, I think it is, and we were like, what? Are you all stupid?
I just can't believe how much we've changed from here.
At the time, we didn't think we looked like awful. Do you know what I mean? But looking back, it's like, oh,
it's been that long ago.
I'm scared now. I'm really scared.
Right, well, starting with Sinead. Sinead would be the one out of all of us to leave something behind. She'd either leave her phone or a pair of trainers or something behind, and we'd always have to go back
and be late for whatever we're going to.
The watch stage, I did get better though.
Just as she got worse again. Manning out of all of us since we first began. Sinead was probably the most that has changed. She had to, like when we first met her, she was kind of ballerina, jazzy dancer type thing. And she's come a long way in her dancing because now she does street dancing and stuff. And I think she's come a long way if you look at our first video tonight.
Kiwi's the one out of all of us who should be telling a story and should have all these different sound effects and faces and funny noises that go with it that make story completely hilarious.
Especially, she's quite shy in a way. I mean, you wouldn't really notice it in the band because she's able to talk to people, but in her own way, she's quite shy, really sensitive.
Too sensitive sometimes.
She's quite daring as well. She'd be the one, like, if we were in a park or something, she'd be like, come on, let's do this roller coaster, the scariest roller coaster. Get
Adele.
When we first moved over to England, myself and Adele, fortunately, we shared a room together, and so we could like get to know all our different things that we do. And one thing that Adele always did was if she had something in her hand and she wanted to put it down somewhere, she would just fire it across the room, and hopefully it would either go into the bin
or
go where exactly where she needed it. And sometimes it got really annoying.
I think out of all of us, Adele would be the most focused in the band. She'll always know where we're going and what we're doing and why we're doing it, and she'll be always like, why are we doing that? Why don't we do it this way? And that'll make it better. And, why are you talking about me?
I think also Adele can be actually quite creative in the way she looks. Like, she always wants her hair a certain way, her makeup, accessories to like go with what she wears. And she's really into kind of like wearing hippie stuff. And
Adele would buy a pair of flares and get our stylist to make them more flary. So we're like,
when we first moved over to England, I used to share a room with
people. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I used to be always the first one to go to bed. So I'd be in bed about 2 hours, and without a doubt, she had like her whole life in a plastic bag. I'm telling you, every time, no matter what time she came in, she would come in and she'd root through a plastic bag and wake me up. What have you got on that plastic bag? When we first moved to England, we used to live in a house together. And every time you'd get up in the morning, Lindsay is so grumpy in the morning. And you'd go, morning, Lindsay. And she'd go, muff. Very, very, very laid back, Lindsay is actually. I mean, if her mobile rings, it'll take her about a year to get it over back.
So
if it stopped ringing, we'd be all like, who was this? And she'd be like, oh, well, then ring me back. Really laid back, and it's like, quick, get it.
If they want me, they'll ring me back.
She always used to want straight hair, and I think she's just got bored with it now. Because she has naturally curly hair. She's like a Barbie doll. You can do whatever you like.
Let's have a look at your videos.
The flying in this video is so bad.
How do we actually do that?
We run hard.
We did that shoot over 2 days. And we were in the harnesses for about 17 hours.
In agony.
Did that hurt? Yeah, I bet that really hurt. Because you're taking your own weight on it as well.
I think actually that was the hardest video we made because
We started at 6 in the morning, we finished like at 2:30, mm-hmm. and then we had to be back up and make up for 6 o'clock the next morning.
Yeah. You won't be making Supergirl the sequel then?
No. And everybody kept saying to us, like, what are these ice lollies all about? And we were like, we're in a fairground, you have to
have ice cream. Here's the next one.
Oh, See Who I Belong. It was something that we really wanted to do, and the video is beautiful.
This song is about your parents, isn't it? It sounds like it's a love song, but it's actually a love song to your parents. Yeah. Why did you decide to do that?
It was something we really wanted to write about, was just our love for our parents, I guess. And we wrote about stories that we kind of had with them, like I cried for you when I hurt my hand, because you always sort of cry for your parents when you hurt yourself. Actually, it's my eye in the video that's opening and closing. Mm-hmm. And when my mum and dad first seen the video, they were like, oh, that's Lindsay's eye. Yeah. I was like, oh, really? I didn't even know my eye. Like, yeah,
your own daughter.
It's just one more day. No one said there would be rain again. I won't blame it on myself. Yeah, I'll blame it on the weatherman. I like this video actually.
How much of this is actually there? Because I'm thinking
just the truck. We're in a pool. We're just in a little like a basin of water, and the truck is cut in half and plonked in.
And we had to do the same scene over and over again, about 100 times that day.
Exactly.
But it was the quickest video actually.
It was good.
We were finished really early. Yeah. You couldn't believe it.
In a day.
Oh, actually, my nephew is so sweet. My nephew is so sweet. Lindsay throws her chain into the water at one stage in the video, and my nephew was like, Lindsay was mad. She didn't throw our jewellery away. And he was very clever as well, actually, because when Sinead took the dog off the door, then he was like, where did that dog go to after that? Because he's not on the truck, he's not anywhere else, so where did you put him back in the water? Rehearsing for our new song Jessie Hold On, and we've picked out a few key points in the video which we're going to teach you now in the dance routine. Alright, so first we're going to start off with the chorus. Right, so spread out, girly. Okay, so first of all, we want your hand up here like as if you're holding a hat, your left hand on your left hip. Okay, so the first step is you just step out for one, then tap your foot and your hand on your hip to go 1, 2, 3, then you go together for 4, drop the arm, yeah, step out your right foot, tap again for 2, and together. Okay, so we're just going to do that with counts now. Are you ready, girl?
Yeah!
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, together, 6, 7, 8. And that's it. And that's because it looks like you're swinging a rope, like in the old Western movies. So it's quite simple really, but we're going to teach it in two separate sections. First of all, we're going to learn the feet, which is step forward, step together, forward, together, 3 and 4 times. And at the same time, you do your arm, which is back and forward, back and forward, back and forward, and again. So try it together now, ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, and 4. Going to do for you is very simple. You start off, put your right leg out, you grab your trousers, and you go down 2, 3 for 3 counts, okay? So we're going to do that together.
You ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, and 1, 2, 3.
Yay!
Okay, now we're gonna do, we're gonna put Lindsay's step in, and then we're gonna put the two steps together, okay?
We'll look out for those tracks for sure. Now, with you being so busy and being everywhere, how are your sort of fans here?
They're cool, actually. A lot of them followed us around on the internet. They logged on to see where we were, and we got a couple of letters.
A couple of emails
and stuff, and that was nice.
They're everywhere, though.
They know our schedule before we do, so I don't know how. I mean, one of the first things we did when we came back, we did a Brighton Roadshow.
Now, before you go on stage, is there a superstition that you'll do before?
Lots. First of all, we'll have to put glitter on all our crew.
Okay.
So that's going to be quite hard.
Even the men?
Even the men. Yeah.
Oh, great.
Yeah. And then just before we go on stage, myself and Adele hug each other last. Mm-hmm. It's really funny because sometimes we start on opposite ends, but if somebody touches one of us, we're like, legging it over the other side to touch her again.
Yeah. Coming soon, isn't it? Tell us a bit about that. What can we expect?
There's loads of different styles on it, actually, like the first one, but it's moved on from there. We've taken another step, and it's probably a bit more mature as well. And there's pop music as usual, and there's some country. There's a bit of American Indian on it.
Okay. Have you had much to do with the writing of this album?
Yeah, we've written all of it.
Yeah,
we've co-written all of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, this week is the week that the single will chart. It was out on Monday. We're up to Thursday. It's going to chart on Sunday. How optimistic are you?
I think we're going to be together, hopefully, on Sunday.
Yeah.
So we'll all
be,
crossing our fingers.
We've been together so far for every Sunday that we found out.
We're looking forward to it, but it's quite hard, though, because everybody else expects the usual.
Yes.
And but we don't expect that at all. We didn't expect it with the other four, and we won't expect it again. Mm-hmm. But everyone else does, and some people are going to go, oh, that's awful if it doesn't happen. But if it doesn't happen, we're still going to be happy once it does well.
Stop getting all nervous now.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
It's been an absolute pleasure. Best of luck on Sunday. Fingers crossed for the single. I'm sure it'll do really well. And good luck with your tour. I'll be there. I'm so already there with my banner.
You'll be there as well. Bye.
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 Oh my God, you actually have an arm sitting on that.
Yes,
buddy. Don't.
1, 2, 3.
No!
When we first moved over to Lindsay, and we all lived in the same house in
Lindsay.
You can't see underneath me, I'm actually sitting on a sheep.
Hello.